Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to another episode of AoW. Now, tonight, we're going to have three matchups. The first of which is going to be our first ever cruiserweight match. And in it is going to be the indie wrestler that I actually met recently, Everett Adams. And the other man, well, that's my little brother, Cameron Harris. So we're looking to see just how good the cruiserweight division is going to be. And well, depending on how that match goes and how the reaction is from the fans, that will determine if the cruiserweights will stay or not. Odds are they're going to stay because, from what I know about these two competitors, they're amazing. And I'm not just saying that because Cameron's my brother. And then after that match, I'll be going one-on-one with Zach Evans to determine which one of us will be the number one contender for the AOW title. And our main event is a match that was actually supposed to be on the main card at AOW Prophecy, but sadly, due to time restraints, was not able to make it on the card. And that's going to be Ryan West going one-on-one with Logan Miller. That's all I have to say here tonight. Thank you all. Hope you enjoy the show. His brother Cameron Harris going one-on-one with a guy that I've also heard of, Everett Adams. I believe that this is going to be Cameron. You know, I'm not going to lie, Justin Harris has great wrestling ability, and as does Haley Harris and Anthony Bell and Jacob Young. So if he's related to Justin Harris and has been trained under those people, he's got to be a great wrestler. But Everett Adams, he's also another one who is just a phenomenal athlete. Cameron Harris definitely knows how to make an entrance, as does Everett Adams, though. In that aspect, I'm not sure who would win there with making an entrance, but I think Everett might actually take the prize for that one. Now for in-ring ability, we're not too sure yet, because, well, we haven't seen any of Cameron Harris. As you all see, there's Everett Adams. Now, maybe they are tied for who made the better entrance here tonight, but making an entrance isn't always the main thing to look at in wrestling. The main thing to look at is the in-ring ability and skill of both men. So now the referee rings the bell. Both men lock up. Cameron Harris has Everett by the arm. But now Adams taking control now. Cameron from behind. Both men trading holds. Oh, and Everett taking him down. But Cameron able to roll out of it. And what's this? Oh, nice clothesline by Everett. Picks Harris up. Oh, man. Jesus, going right after that left arm of Harris. Now, picks him up. Nice backspin kick. Oh. These kicks. Oh, man. Harris just collapses. So far, he has had little to no offense. Harris thrown over the top rope onto the apron. And Everett with a drop kick. Dropping him on the outside. And look at this dive. Oh, never mind. Usually Everett will go for a dive. I guess not. Oh man, nice basement dropkick right to the left kneecap of Cameron Harris. But Harris now with a dragon screw takedown. Now throwing Everett into the corner. What's this? Oh man, nice leaping big boot right to the face. And now a nice cannonball senton. Now Harris off the ropes. Oh man, into a rocket kick. To the gut. What's this? Oh, look at this. Has him in a pump handle position, but never mind. Everett, amazing reversal there. And hits Harris with a back suplex. Now Everett with a standing crucifix moonsault. Goes to the pin. One. No. Harris able to kick out before the count of two. And oh, nice drop kick right to the back of the head. What's he looking for now? Oh, never mind. Harris with the knee to the face. And, oh, drops an elbow right into the chest of Everett Adams. Now throws Everett against the ropes. Oh, lets him run back. Nice clothesline taking him out of the ring. Was Cameron setting him up for here. Oh, man. Wow, just running and jumping through the ropes and hitting Everett with a suicide dive. Slamming Everett's face right into the announce table top. And now, Everett returning the favor. Now throws Cameron back into the ring. So, what can we do here? Nice European uppercut. Oh, has him tangled up in the ropes now. Oh, geez. Look at these knees right to the skull. Now what's he looking for here? A big boot taking Cameron to the outside. What's Everett looking for here? Oh man, returning the favor to Cameron Harris with that suicide dive. Now what's this? Nice clothesline to Cameron Harris. As the referee starts the count. Throws Harris back into the ring. Kick to the gut. What's he looking for here? Everett. Oh man. Has Harris up and hits him with a brainbuster. One of Everett's signature maneuvers here as he goes for the pin. Two, he may have him, but no. Everett obviously very frustrated there, as anyone would be. And oh, nice perfect moonsault. And that picks Cameron up. Oh, never mind. Harris with a jawbreaker. Kick to the gut. What's he looking for here? And oh man, nice suplex powerbomb combo. Shades of Justin Harris. It's obviously a move they learned from his brother as he goes to the pin. Everett able to kick out once again. Well, both men have been kicking out of each other's moves. And, oh, a drop kick right to the back. Now throwing Everett into the corner. What's this? throws him to the outside. Oh, never mind. Ever able to hang on. And a drop kick. Taking him down. What's Cameron looking to do here? This big, oh, never mind, as I say, big moonsault, but ever able to move out of the way and hits him with an arm drag. Everett now going back into the ring. Gonna let Cameron get back in himself. Both men charge at each other, but this time Cameron taking the advantage. Very similar situation from earlier in the match when Everett was able to take control. A drop kick. What's this arm wrench into a drop kick? Oh man, a kick right to the back. Now is Cameron looking to do here? Oh man, some straight kicks right to the face. I believe, yeah, Everett Adams is busted open after that. And Cameron with a suplex. Now throws Everett in. Oh, never mind. Brings him back. Into a knee right to the gut. Oh, man. And just kicking him in the ribs. Knee to the chest. Backhand chop. And Everett with the reversal. What's he doing here? Up on the top rope. Right above Cameron. Oh, man. Straight punches to the top of the head. Has him down the corner. Everett drops down. And, oh man, nice drop kick right to the face. Falls over the kick to the back. And, dragon screw by Cameron Harris. What was he looking for here? Cameron. With a super kick, and Everett comes back with his own. Oh my god, what an amazing combination there. Cameron Harris hit Everett with a super kick, and Everett came right back with one of his own. And now Everett goes to the pin. Is that going to put him away? One, two, no. Cameron somehow, someway able to kick out there. Harris now making his way back to his feet. As Everett throws him into the corner. What's he looking to do here? Pass him up. Everett. Oh, looks like going for a spider suplex. Now, Everett. Looking for a red arrow, but no. Harris able to roll out of the way. Kick to the gut. Oh, look at this. Cameron with a future shock DDT. Is that going to put Everett Adams away? Or is he going to be able to fight through it? Now, goes to the pin on Everett. One, two, three. He got him. Wow, an absolutely amazing matchup by both men. And even though Cameron Harris won this matchup, I think both men here are the winners. As in my opinion, this is just my opinion, they have solidified the cruiserweight division, and I think that it's here to stay. In my opinion, there was no dull point in this matchup. It was just exciting throughout the entire way. Here's that epic moment in this matchup, that double super kick combination. Here's a move that put Everett Adams away. The future shock DDT. Well, congratulations to Cameron Harris on your first ever win in your first ever match on AOW. Next matchup is going to be Zach Evans going one-on-one with the owner of AOW, Justin Harris, to fight for his number one contendership for the AoW title. Now here comes Zach Evans, who will be the first to enter this matchup. Justin Harris will be coming out next. Think about it, Evans should already have a rematch because he was the last champion and Isaac Taylor beat him for it. Zach Evans was put through hell in that matchup, especially that Samoan drop onto the announce table. Wait a minute, Justin Harris. Oh, a drop kick right to the back of Zach Evans. Justin Harris just jumping Evans before the match can even begin. Oh man, just throwing him to the floor. Now throws Evans into the ring. Referee rings the bell now. And oh, Harris with a backstabber. Now throws Evans in the corner. Man, just stomping him in that corner. Jeez. Harris showing absolutely no remorse here. As now, yes, Evans up in a torture rack position and hits him with a neck breaker. Harris goes to the pin. One. No, not able to get the two count. And oh god, a knee right to the skull of Zach Evans. Harris with a knee to the face. Oh, look at this, just smacking the face of Zach Evans. And wait a minute, Evans with a backslide driver goes to the pin. One. No, not even able to get the two count. Evans now throws Harris into the corner. Oh, suckers him in and hits him with that pendulum kick. As now Evans with a small package roll up. One, two, no. Oh man, look at that, just stomping away at Harris. Oh, punch right to the rib cage. Now what's Evans looking for here? A knee right to the face of Harris, getting some payback there. This has Harris in between the top and middle rope, and oh, just slamming his skull right into the mat. Now goes to the pin. One, two, no. Harris barely able to get the shoulder up. Now throws Harris into the corner, and oh, misses the clothesline. Now, oh my god, I'm not sure if Harris connected right with what he was going for there. I mean, he took Evans down the other way, but I don't even know what happened there. Now, Harris with a swinging mic check. Goes to the pin, looking to put Evans away. One, two, three, no. Evans now barely able to get his shoulder up. Throws Evans into the corner. Oh, Evans able to block the kick and reverses the tables on him. And once again, suckering Harrison with that pendulum kick. Now takes him on the clothesline. Oh my god, just stomping on the chest of Justin Harris. And now, I'm not sure who he's going for there, but Harris reverses into a Russian leg sweep. Oh, just slap to the face of Zach Evans, and Harris off the ropes into a suicide forearm smash. Look at that, Harris just forearming Evans in the face. As the referee starts the count, Harris picking Evans back up, throws him right into the barricade. But Evans, with an arm drag, taking control. Oh man, throws Harris into the barricade. And what's this? Oh, lifts him up. Oh my god, slams him face first into the barricade. And on top of the barricade. Right for the count of five, and once again, slamming him face first into the barricade. But what's this? The Zack Attack on the outside. Now, Evans and Harris back into the ring. Zack going for the pin. One, two, three. No! Once again, Justin Harris able to get the shoulder up. Obviously, Zack Evans very frustrated with that. As you'd expect anybody to be. And wait a minute, Harris with a belly-to-belly suplex. And Evans kind of caught the turnbuckles. Oh, turns around right with a forearm smash. And another one. Oh! Oh my god, nice little sequence there. Usually falls over the Pele kick, but instead ducked the clothesline and hit him with a super kick. Now Harris must be very frustrated now. As Evans up on the top rope. What's this? Harris looking for a back suplex. Oh, never mind. Evans reverses it into a crossbody. Now goes to the pin on Harris. One, two, no. Harris able to kick out once again. Throws Harris into the corner. What's this? Oh my god! Just throwing Harris into the turnbuckles. That T-bone suplex. Exploder suplex. So now Evans gets hyped up. Hits him with a clothesline. Into a bulldog. Evans is on fire right now. And I'm sure he's hoping that that doesn't stop. And, oh, I believe he's going for the back suplex side slam. But Harris able to reverse it into a bulldog. Now, it's this kick combination. And, oh, drop kick right to the face. Harris wasting very little time now. Man, he's just going right at Evans. This. Oh my god, just throwing him face first into the second turnbuckle. Now goes to the pin. One, two, no. Honestly, I have no idea how Evans is still going. You know, when we first heard about this match. Oh wait, Evans! Reversing. I believe Harris is going for a curb stomp. And he reversed into a cutter. Oh man, slams Harrison's face right onto his knee. Anyways, as I was saying, when I first heard about this match, I wasn't too sure who I'd be rooting for, but oddly enough, I'm rooting for Zack Evans. And now, he has Harris for the cross-arm brainbuster. Goes to the pin. This is going to be it for Justin Harris. One, two, three, no. Justin Harris able to kick out once again. Up, Zack Evans is becoming the underdog in this matchup. Now, Evans looks to be placing Justin Harris up on top. Jeez, look at all the blood running down Harris' face. He just busted wide open. Oh, what's this? Evans possibly looking for a butterfly suplex off the top rope. Oh, God. Picks Harris back up. An elbow right to the back of the head. Oh, Harris not like that one bit. And hits him with a Pele kick. Kick to the gut. That was in a pump handle position. Oh, God. Pump handle gut buster there by Justin Harris. stomp right on the rib cage. Man. Justin Harris, cocky as ever. Oh man. Just kicking at the face of Zach Evans. Well, yes, possibly looking for a super kick. Oh, Evans able to duck it. And look at this. Evans with a small package roll up. One, two, no. Harris once again able to kick out. Oh no, but Justin able to take control now. And look at this. Moonsault by Justin Harris, but Evans with a kick to the face. Has him in the clothesline, taking him down. Stomps are so lethal. Oh, wait, look at this. Oh, has Harris in a triangle hold. Is he gonna make Harris tap? No, I guess not. Lifts him up. Nice back spin kick. Reverses the back elbow into an elbow of his own, really. And look at the back suplex side slam. No, Harris once again reverses it. Ooh, a bulldog. Now Harris, kick to the gut. And hits him with a curb song. Man, Evans, looks like he's really hurt. It's a referee checking on him. Now Harris goes for the pin. That's it. One, two, three. Justin Harris will be going one-on-one with Isaac Taylor at our next CPV. You know, there were a bunch of moments in this matchup where I thought and I hoped that Justin Harris was going to lose, and Zach Evans just wasn't able to get the job done tonight. I mean, either way, that was still an amazing match and performance put on by both men. Stomp, the final move that put away Zach Evans. Well, it should definitely be one hell of a match. And our next CPV, what's Harris doing here? Harris going after Evans. Oh, throwing him into the barricade. This now has him laying on the barricade. Oh god, a boot right to the side of the head. What's this all about? I mean, he beat him. I get that, but this is just ridiculous. And oh man, spinning mic check by Harris. Oh no, here we go again. Evans. Oh god, Harris was curb stomping his face in. Well, that done. It's time to move on to our main event. Coming up first, it's gonna be Logan Miller. And if you don't remember, before Prophecy, Ryan West was coming out. Not sure who he's going to be going against, but out of nowhere, Logan Miller just came out and pretty much dismantled him. And as you heard from Justin Harris, this match was originally supposed to be on the Prophecy show, but sadly, it was cut due to time restraints. So, that's why we're just going to get to see it here tonight. You all know the story here. The Ritual of the Madness consisted of Logan Miller, Corey Adams, Ryan West, and technically Zach Evans. Now, since then, the Madness pretty much just consists of Logan Miller and Corey Adams. And for a while, Ryan West was with them still, but he decided that he was going to leave the Madness and, well, go on his own personal journey. Obviously, that did not sit very well with, well, Logan Miller and Corey Adams. So Miller decided he was going to do something about it, and, well, like I said before, he pretty much destroyed West. Now, here is Ryan West. Honestly, I think that leaving the Madness was one of the best decisions West has ever made. Everything started with Ryan West after he got injured against Justin Harris. When he came back, he just honestly wasn't really with the Madness anymore. He accompanied them to the ring once or twice, but that was the last time they were all together. And now, West and Miller are going to be going one-on-one now. The referee rings the bell. Both men lock up. Miller takes West by the arm, but West, the reversal, has been a hold of his own and takes him down. Wow, West actually letting Miller get up. Oh, goes for a forearm, but misses wildly. And West, the European uppercut. Oh God, knee right to the skull. Now throws Miller into the ropes. Oh, knee right to the gut. And another one. What's this now? West with a Russian leg sweep. Now, oh man, boots. West knee, and now has been a small package. One. No, not even at the two count. Miller dropping the leg over Ryan West. So now Miller throws West into the corner. Backhand chop. And another one. Oh man. Chops hitting him so hard he fell to the floor. Just stomping him. Now throws West into the ropes. Drops down under. Oh. Nice. Love to the face, and hits with a Northern Lights suplex. One. No, not even get the one, or not even get the two count. And stomps down on Logan Miller. Not sure if I'd call that payback or not, but I will just because I can. Oh God, straight punch to the face. What's this? Oh God, Wes, with some, well, reverse stomps, I guess. See how Miller likes it when that's done to him. Oh man, I'm not gonna lie, that was a nice reversal there by Miller. And nice back suplex by Miller. Taking down West. This nice backbreaker neckbreaker combination. Oh man, stomps right on the arm. And oh, doing exactly what West did to him a few minutes ago. And Miller with the tiger bomb goes to the pin. One. No, West able to kick out before the count of two. West into the corner. And, oh, nice clothesline. Now Miller up on the second rope. Telling West to get up. And nice crossbody. Goes to the pin. One, two, no. Miller picking West back up now. Oh, but West with a punch in the face. The backhand shot. Oh, and drop kick sends Miller out of the ring. The referee starts the count. West throws Miller right into the steel steps. Oh man, look at that, throwing Miller over the barricade into the crowd. West gets back into the ring. As does Miller. Oh man, I was not expecting that. Miller kicks the gut, hits him with a leg trap DDT. Now goes to the pin. One, two, no. West barely able to kick out. Now, what's Miller looking to do here? Clothesline taking West out of the ring. Oh, what's this? Possibly looking for a suicide dive, and he hits it. You know, something that I've kind of noticed in this matchup so far is that when one man does something to the other man comes back with him with almost the same thing. And for example, near the beginning of the match, when Miller had West in the corner, he kept hitting him until he fell to the ground, and he just kept stomping on him. Well, West took back control, he threw Miller into the corner and got him down to the ground with a bunch of strikes and stomped him in the corner. And I don't know. Oh my god. The terminating spike on the outside, on the concrete. Like, there's a part where between the padding on the outside and the ramp where it's just pure concrete, and he just dropped Miller's skull on that. And I don't know how, but he was able to kick out of that. So you can just tell by the look on West's face. He's like, how? Oh, but Miller with a kip up. Misses the kick. Clothesline by Miller. Has Miller another one. Catches the foot and sweeps the leg. Now Miller. I was looking for the discus big boot. And oh god! That boot right to the face. Goes to the pin. One, two, three. No! Punching West in the face. And stomping him down to the mat. It's again punching him in the face. Oh man, I think West is busted open. Oh yeah, he definitely is. As now Ryan takes control. Picks him up. Clothesline. Nice calf kick. Picks Miller up. What's this? West with the Falcon Arrow. Oh. Look at this. West looking for the black magic. He's going to be able to hit it. And, oh, never mind. Miller able to get out of it. West misses a kick, but Miller misses a punch. Man. But now, Miller with his elbows. Ooh. Nice elbow right to the top of the head. And now, he turns him over. Look at this. Oh no, not this move. I have not seen him do this move in quite some time. And Miller. Oh no. Oh god. I don't know how anybody can just withstand that amount of pain. And oh, West with a punch right to the left eye. And clothesline takes him down. Lace him up. Oh, never mind. Miller with the European uppercut. And what's this? Oh, I think he was looking for the sit-out tombstone. But West with the reversal. What's this? Oh, man, a punch right to the back. Oh, no. Oh, jeez. Just a knee around the chest. West now getting back into the ring. West, the Scorpion Death Drop. And West possibly looking to put Miller away here. As once again, going for Black Magic. And he's able to hit it. Ryan West connects with Black Magic. And that just might put Logan Miller away here. Now, stomping on his kidney area. Oh, wait a minute, look at this. West with the Anaconda Vice. A move that Logan Miller actually taught him how to do when he taps out. Wow, Ryan West hitting the corner over Logan Miller here tonight. Honestly, out of the three matches, I don't know if I can pick which one I thought was better because they were all just amazing. Great effort by Logan Miller, but Ryan West comes out the victor. Here's the move that put Miller away, the Anaconda Vice. It's kind of ironic how West made Miller tap out to a move that he taught him how to do. Congratulations, Ryan West. What's this? I think he's done here. Ooh, hits him with a leg drop. Now, oh man, just punched him in the face. Hammering away at him. Oh my god. Jesus. There's a difference between getting revenge and just pure madness. And that's exactly what this is. Ryan West just unloading. Oh my god, look at all that blood coming from the face of Logan Miller. He's finally done. Corey Adams now making his way down the ramp. Oh no, this is not going to be good for Ryan West at all. Wait, what the? So wait, what's going on here? Corey putting Miller into the corner. What's going on? West just looking on. What? Wait a minute, what the? No. Corey hitting Miller with the buckle bomb. Oh no. Is this it for the madness? Now just throwing Miller to the outside. Wait a minute. Oh, God. Just coming at West with a spear. Corey Adams, let me know where he stands in this. This is every man for himself. He's not the good guy nor the bad guy in this situation. He's doing what's best for him, I guess, is the only way that we could describe this. Now, Corey. The spear to the... Oh my god, spear to Miller through that barricade. The crowd chanting, this is awesome. I mean, I guess. Well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you all for watching this episode of AoW. And, well, we'll see you all on the next episode.